just trying to dial in the new Pro wheel I got. It's a lot different than the G29. So, I mean, there's a lot of settings on the wheel itself, and in the game I had to change just to get it even comfortable. Still not where I want it at, but not doing too bad. Definitely feel a lot more with this wheel than what I did on the G29. Off the track, and hold the lines better. Six. That's a good lap. That even broke the goal time. Sweet. Oh, wow. Says my records is a 12.332 from when I was playing earlier. That's like 0.2 of a second faster than anything on the leaderboards, I think. I ran that 12.3. Real field. Try a different track. Been having trouble changing car classes too, where it's losing force feedback. So I'm going to try that. Let's try UMP modifieds. I'm good at Fairbury, so let's try that. If I can click my normal laps off with this, then I know I got the wheel set pretty close. Fairbury Speedway, America's dirt track. We've got some cars coming out on the track now for hot laps. No force feedback. that's all, no. Absolutely no force field. I wonder if I need to set the wheel from pro mode into G29, maybe. We can try that. Compatibility, G923. Restart the wheel. See if this makes a difference. Maybe it's not compatible with the Pro. Felt good. But I don't know why it keeps losing it like that. Now I got force feedback back. Practice. I normally run my quicker laps and track changes a little bit. Well, that felt good. Let's try. I'm curious if it's just when you change classes. Or if it's just when you change tracks. So let's try Kokomo.
We're in Indiana today, side of the... Drivers are hitting the track for hot laps.
No force feedback.
Thank you.
That is very odd. Shows I should have force feedback though. Hitting the wall and everything else, I've got nothing. And the wheel's kind of stiff. I don't understand that. Let me try turning the wheel off and back on. That's pretty stupid if I'm gonna have to do that every fucking time for a new track. Low there. So I ran an 11.1. My best. I pulled an 11.4. Start this. Oh! That about jerked it out of my wheel by accident. So switching to G29 mode does not seem to have any effect on why I'm losing force speed.
Let's check out the leaderboard.
So for the hell of it, does it lose between sessions? It does not. 11. Not a great lap by any means.
The qualifying results are up.
So, completely quit out of this. I think what's happened is it's going to the menu and it's losing force feedback. There's another one I got a good setup for. I'll try Volusia.
We're
that time it felt like it reloaded the wheel.
Time for some hot laps to see what they've got.
It did not. Let's try something. So it says I can, so it's not anything with the G29 or the Pro or the 923 compatibility, because it's doing it on both. Now I have it back. So force feedback is back. Let's try. And this back out. Let's try the same track. Back out the same track. I want to see if it's sending force feedback data. I gotta figure this out. Where is home screen, dynamic test, profile, torque? There we go. This is displaying what I'm getting for force feedback.
We're just outside Barberville, Florida. The track is green for hot laps.
Nothing. No force. So, let's try switching to profile just for the hell of it. No force feedback, but it changed the angle and everything. Like showing maybe peeking out at 1.5 newton meters of force when it's set at like 10. There's no resistance on the wheel, nothing. Like no feedback coming through at all on anything. So let's try actually going into the options and see if there's something I can change. I have P2 controls now. I did not have that before. I don't know if it needs to be set there or not, but I think that's what I set it at. Oh, 90. 90 on. No, 40 and 45. 90 on. I did that backwards. 40 and 45. I don't know why. I'm losing force feedback. Between races, though. It's like it's not loading it back up for some reason. I did not have this problem on a G29. Firmware is updated on this. Game's updated, obviously, of course. I don't think it really matters where I go. I just want to see if I have force feedback. Doesn't feel like it. No force feedback. So, I'm gonna have to figure this one out. I wonder if it needs to be set. I wonder if it makes a difference if it's set for PS4 versus PS5. Or platform. Gives me PS5, PS4, and PC. We will try PS4, even though this is a PS5 version of the game. Just for the hell of it, and see if it makes a difference. No force now. Turn the wheel off. Controller disconnected. Wait a couple seconds. Turn it back on. If I have to do this all the time, I'm going to be kind of pissed. Especially, you can't do this online. Force feedback is definitely back. Yeah, I'm hitting the wall. Now it's peeking out at like different intervals. force going up higher than what it was before. It's there, I can feel it. I just about ripped it out of my hand, hitting the wall head on. So now is a moment.
All lap times are in. Let's take a look.
So if I leave the track, there's no torque on it. I'll just try the next one in line. Not touching anything on the throttle, brake, the wheel, or anything else.
We're at the speed palace for today's race, the half-mile port miles.
Don't care about the setup.
Hot laps are underway.
No forced feedback. Am I losing my force feedback? Well, I guess it's time to stop this video and investigate.